Welcome to the Abundance of Grace, the teaching and preaching ministry of Pastor Stephen McCrary. Join us today for another powerful look into the Word of God.
Hold on to God. Hold on to wisdom. And the money will come. Why? Because money follows God. Divine prosperity follows God. Goodness and mercy follows God. The reason why goodness and mercy is going to follow you, thank you, Lord, the days of your life, all the day, because he is your shepherd and you are following the shepherd. And when you follow the shepherd, everything that follows the shepherd follows you. Let me say that again. When you are following the shepherd, everything that follows the shepherd follows you. Hello, everybody. Stephen McCrary here again with the Abundance of Grace. And I'm glad you joined me for part four of the Grace for Wisdom. The Grace for Wisdom. Wisdom, remember, wise, dumb, dominion, control, your area, having wisdom for your area, whatever you're up under, whatever you control, having wisdom for that, having understanding for that, and how you get that by God, by the Holy Spirit. So we're going to go into part four today. Let's pray. Father, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you once again. McCrary, you know, don't have a lot to say, but you do. I thank you for your grace. I thank you for your mercy. I thank you for your peace. I thank you for your joy. I thank you for understanding. Lord, make my mouth as the pen of a ready writer. Say something today that will revolutionize, that will impact, that will bring abundance to your people, abundance to their mind, abundance to their spirit, abundance to their life. Bless their children. Bless their marriages. Bless their relationships. Bless the things, Lord, that they are touching. Lord, bless their businesses. Bless their entrepreneurial pursuits. Whatever they are doing in their life, Lord, it is called by your name. Bless them in the name of Jesus. Bring divine grace and prosperity. In Jesus' name, I give you praise and I thank you for your anointing. I receive it now. I receive the spirit of wisdom as it pertains to teaching your word this day in the name of Jesus. Amen. So last week, you know, we were talking about choosing instructions rather than silver. We kind of got stuck there. And choosing great decisions and knowledge rather than gold. We talked about that. So if you missed that, I want you to go back and listen to that and watch that. But I want to go a little further into this Proverbs 8. Remember, Solomon was the wisest man. Wise. And I'm going to teach you in a couple weeks why that was. And we're going to dissect his life. We are going to dissect the decision that he made to bring this great wisdom and subsequently the great wealth. So we must listen. Remember, I told you last week, if Warren Buffett gives you some investment advice, it may be wise for you to listen when you don't know what he knows and you don't know what God knows. Wisdom was with God from the beginning. Wisdom was with God when God created the earth, when he created the world, when he created the universe. Wisdom was there. Wisdom was there when he slung out Jupiter and Saturn and Mars and Venus and Pluto. Wisdom was there. Wisdom was there when he hollowed out the earth and he made the waters go back and called the waters to come forth. It was wisdom was there. Wisdom was there when he made the dandelion and he made the lion and the tiger and the bear and the rat. Wisdom was there. You weren't. Wisdom was. So it may be wise to get a hold of this thing we called wisdom, to get a hold of the divine knowledge that God offers all those that ask. And we're going to get into that in a couple weeks. It may be wise to listen. It may be wise to listen. Because if your life is going one way and you envision your life going the other, but remember I told you last week, when you're following the shepherd, your life should be going a certain way. Do we have issues? Yes. Do we have troubles? Yes. But wisdom will teach us how to get out the trouble. Wisdom will teach us how to sometimes even go around the trouble. We don't always have to go through the trouble, the mountaintop. Yeah, sometimes you can go around. But divine wisdom will show us how to do that. So, Proverbs 8, this week, verse 11. For wisdom is far more valuable, than rubies. Wait a minute. For wisdom is far more valuable. So if you're looking at a table here, okay, if you're looking at a graph, The graph has rubies here. Now, if I tell you that something is far more valuable than rubies, far more valuable, and it's interesting because God last week was dealing with silver and gold. He was making the case that wisdom and knowledge is more valuable than silver and gold. Now, when you are carnal, if you will, you will debunk that because you'll say, well, no, gold is, and pure gold, oh my goodness, pure gold? You're telling me that knowledge is more valuable than pure gold? No, 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 to God it is. And this is who we are focused on. So God last week was dealing with silver and gold, and this week he's dealing with rubies. Silver, gold, and rubies. Now to the natural person, you're going to say, wait a minute, ain't no way wisdom is better than silver, gold, and rubies. Wisdom is better than silver, gold, and rubies? I'm going to tell you it is. You know how? Because wisdom can show you how to get the silver, the gold, and the rubies, and other things. Great relationships, a great marriage, a great second marriage, and for some folks, a great third marriage when you tap into wisdom. Wisdom can teach you how to raise great children, great relationships. So you focus on the rubies, the silver, and the gold, but wisdom is focused on the full package. You remember that I think it was a few months ago that I was talking about when you choose Christ rather than what he has, you get everything that he wants you to have. In other words, you can have a car or you can have Christ, but inside Christ, you got everything you need. You got the car, you got everything that he wants you to have. But if you choose something that's just a part of him, but not him, then you have that, but then you don't have him. It's always better to choose the unending supply. I think that's what I'm trying to say. It's better to choose the unending supply rather than to choose the little. I was thinking about Adam and Eve and how God told them, now, I don't want you to eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. It would have made sense. Now, this is me. And I'll probably ask Adam about this at some point. I'm going to ask both of them. Why wouldn't you all choose to eat from the tree of life? That baffles me. Why wouldn't you choose to eat from the tree? He didn't tell you couldn't eat from the tree of life. He told you not to eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. So it would have seemed to me that you would have picked the best tree to eat from, which was the tree of life. The tree of life, you could live forever and ever and ever. That just didn't make sense to me. It's like, I want to eat from the tree that he told me not to eat from, rather than to eat from the tree that will give me eternal life forever and ever and eternal bliss. But anyway, I was thinking about that the other day, and maybe you'll think about it now, but we'll ask Adam and Eve when we meet them. How about that? So anyway, let's get back to rubies, gold, and silver. Rubies, gold, and silver. Rubies, gold, and silver. Wisdom. Have you ever seen people that have a lot of money, but yet and still they're not happy? Have you seen people with a lot of money and yet and still they may die early or die of something that just ravaged their body? Have you ever seen that? Or they commit suicide? And you wonder, man, they got all that money, they got all that's going for them, and they kill themselves? No. They did not have wisdom from God. They may have had some knowledge on how to perform or how to dance or how to do something, but they didn't have that divine wisdom, that divine knowledge from the Holy Spirit. They had money. That's why he said, choose wisdom rather than silver. Choose knowledge rather than pure gold. And this week he tells us, for wisdom is far more valuable, far more valuable. Not just a little more valuable, but far more valuable than rubies. So if you're going to choose something, choose wisdom. It's far more valuable. 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 When something is valuable, it's generally rare. It's precious. Value has a lot to do with how precious and rare this commodity is. Yes, value has everything to do with how rare it is, how precious it is. Wisdom is precious. Why? Because you can't buy it. You can't buy it. It has to be given. Your mama can't give it to you. Your daddy can't give it to you. Books can't give it to you. The professor can't give it to you. The teacher can't give it to you. The only one that can give you wisdom is God. Is God. That's why it's valuable. And that's why it's rare. Because most people don't go after it. They go after the gold, the silver, and the rubies. They don't go after wisdom. And they never understand that it is wisdom that can bring you gold, silver, and rubies. I'm going to deal with this. I'm going to deal with it in a little bit. Stay with me. Stay with me. The second part of Proverbs 8:11, nothing you desire can compare with it. Nothing you desire can compare with it. Compare with what? Compare with wisdom. Nothing you can desire. That good woman you want. Oh, yes. That good woman you want with the nice teeth and the nice body and the nice hair and the nice face, the beauty of the woman with the nice figure. Yeah, that thing you desire, that man that you want with the six pack and the bulging biceps and triceps and the legs that look like rocks of Gibraltar, you know, that man you want with the money and all the prestige and, you know, the different stuff people want. Mm-hmm. That glorious house in the Hamptons, that glorious house in the suburbs, the four bedrooms, the four bathrooms, you know, the sprawling yard, all that, you know, just the sprawling floor plan. Yeah, that job you want, you know, that six-figure job, mm-hmm. The six-figure job that's going to pay you real well and give you great benefits and give you great health coverage, all that. Nothing that you desire. You know, because we desire a lot of stuff. That health we desire. You know, the health, you know, the good cholesterol, the good heart rate, the blood pressure that's 120 over 80, the great sugar levels, nothing that you desire. The three kids that you want, or the two kids, and you want them to do great things in life. Nothing that you desire. To have a worldwide ministry, or to have a worldwide company, or to start a business, and that business go to all 50 states, and then go into China, and go into Russia, and go into nothing that you desire. Nothing that you can compare. God says it can't even compare to wisdom. It can. And so what I'm hearing, what I keep hearing week after week that I'm teaching is, what I keep hearing is, choose wisdom among it all, and that other stuff, wisdom can show you how to get it. Choose wisdom, choose wisdom, choose wisdom, I choose wisdom. And it would seem to me that would be the better choice, because wisdom will show you what business. Wisdom will show you what woman. Wisdom will show you what man. And let me deal with this right quick, even in relationships. And some of us have jacked relationships up. I'll be the first one to admit it. We've jacked relationships up. Wisdom will show you where you messed up and what to do different the second time or the third time or some the fourth time. Money can't show you that. Wisdom. Because wisdom will show you. Everybody's to fault. But wisdom will show you where you messed up and where you need to correct and what you need to do to go into something else.
Introducing Pastor Stephen's new book, 30 Days of Grace. For any size gift to the ministry, we will send you this powerful devotional that will walk you through 30 days of God's abundance of grace. For more details, go to our website at www.aograce.com.
Hallelujah. Money can't show you that. Rubies can't show you that. Diamonds can't show you that. Pearls can't show you that. Silver can't show you that. Gold can't show you that. Wisdom. Lord, see into me and show me myself, because I don't want to make that mistake again. Wisdom. 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 I keep saying it. I want it ringing in your ear. Lord, give me wisdom. Lord, give me wisdom. We said last week, you want goodness and mercy to follow you? Get wisdom. Get wisdom. Wisdom is far valuable than rubies. Nothing you desire can compare with it. Listen, it ain't even in the same ballpark. Ain't even, there is no competition. There is not, listen, wisdom is the principal thing. Wisdom, wisdom, wisdom. Nothing you desire can't compare with it. I can't get off of that. Can't get off of that. And you all know we run after everything else. We run after everything. But nothing that you desire can't compare with it. It is the greatest. It is the greatest. Verse 12, I, wisdom, live together with good judgment. I know where to discover knowledge and discernment. Oh, my goodness. I, wisdom, live together with good judgment. Good judgment. That means I'm going to keep you out of trouble. When you make good judgments, it keeps you out of trouble. When you make good judgment, it keeps you out of harm's way. When you make good judgment, it keeps you out of the things maybe that could do you harm later on. That means I'm not going to go to that party because there may be something popping off up in there. So good judgment is going to tell me I may need to keep my hips at home. I may need not to hang out with that set of friends. Wisdom is going to show me that. Not money, not gold, not rubies, not silver. But then check this out. Wisdom says, I live together with good judgment. I know where to discover knowledge and discernment. I know where to discover. I know where to discover. I know where to discover. So when you follow me, oh my goodness, I feel the power of God. When you follow me, when you follow me, when you follow me, I'm going to show you the secret places. I'm going to show you the hidden things. I'm going to show you some good stocks to invest in, some good bonds to buy. Because why? Because I know where to discover knowledge and discernment. I'm discerning. You may not need to make that move or pull your money out of here and put it over here or start this kind of business in this pandemic. And I'm going to show you that I can bless you through the pandemic because of my discernment and my knowledge. This is what wisdom is going to bring you. This is what wisdom is going to bring you. I'm going to show you how to invest in gold or how to invest in, not run after it, invest in it. I'm going to show you, I'm going to bring you into a place where you may be lonely and you meet that man or you meet that woman, discernment, knowledge. You may reject one, but fall in love with the other. Come on, come on. We're living in real life here. We're living in real life here. Discernment is something about this one that I'm loving, that I'm liking, that I'm falling in love with. It's something about this one. Discernment. Knowledge. I'm discovering knowledge with wisdom and discernment. I'm discovering knowledge and wisdom and discernment. Why? Because I'm going after wisdom. I'm not just trying to go after some knowledge of some book knowledge, reading a whole bunch of autobiographies, which you should read your Bible, personal self-development, read some of the great sages of our ages and their life, yes. But you got to ask for the divine wisdom and the divine knowledge, because it's going to teach me how to navigate through my life. going to teach me how to navigate through my relationships? How's it going to teach me how to navigate raising my children in this world? Divine strategies, that's what I'm hearing in my spirit. God says, I want to give you divine strategies for your life. I want to give you divine strategies for your family. I want to give you divine strategies for your body. I want to give you divine strategies for your business. I want to give you divine strategies for your money. He said, I don't want you going after the money. He said, but I want to give you divine strategies on how to use it. What to invest in, what to stay away from. What's the next thing that's going to bless this world? Crypto or stocks or whatever. God says, I wisdom know all things from the beginning. I know where to discover knowledge. And when you're walking with me, when you're walking with me, wisdom is saying, you'll discover knowledge too and discernment. Good judgment, discovering knowledge, and discernment. Let me say it again. Good judgment, discovering knowledge, and discernment. And that's the full gamut. That's the full deal. God says, I just don't want to give you a piece of the pie. He's saying, I want to give you the whole pie. Money is just a piece of the pie. But God says, I want to give you the whole pie. I want to give you good judgment, discernment, and I want to give you knowledge, discovering knowledge. Discovering knowledge. People say, that's something about that guy. Or is there something about that girl? Something about them. And listen, when you get good judgment, and you discover knowledge, and you discover discernment, money gonna come now. Money come. Listen, money comes to wisdom. Come on now. Money, now y'all know that. Money comes to wisdom. How can you have good judgment, discovering knowledge, and discernment, and you have this thing that rubies, gold, and silver cannot compare to, and you stay broke? Impossible. Impossible. Solomon had wisdom, but Solomon also had some money. He had some greenbacks. He had some cash. He had some guac. He had some cheddar. He had some cheese. Yes, he did. But he had, more than anything, divine wisdom. And we're going to talk about Solomon next week, and I'm going to show you why he had it. I'm going to show you why he had it. It's going to shock you. Because I'm going to show you some things you've never seen before. It's going to shock you. But check this out. He says now, I wisdom. I live together. I live together. With good judgment. Moral things. Good judgment is just having moral character. This will keep you out of jail. Hallelujah, this will keep you out of jail. Because you're going to make the right decisions, okay? And you're not going to falsify contracts, okay? And you're not going to steal money, uh-huh? And you're not going to take things that don't belong to you. Good judgment, good judgment, good judgment. Because God says, I want to bless you, and so you don't have to always look over your shoulder. You don't have to always look over your shoulder. You know, always you're going to get caught. No, if you're going to get caught, we got to get caught doing the right thing. If we're going to get caught, we got to get caught giving the right counsel, giving the right judgment, good judgment. I wisdom, live together. It's just, you know, only thing that's happening here is wisdom is trying to make a case for itself. It can stand on its own. I told you wisdom stands. And when wisdom stands, wisdom can see anything and everything. Wisdom just don't see, not seated. Wisdom stands. And anytime you're standing, you can see everything around you. Everything around you. So he said now, I live together with good judgment. I'm making a case for myself. And the reason I'm making a case for myself, wisdom says, is because I want to invade your life. I, wisdom, live together with good judgment. I know where to discover knowledge and discernment. Now, if somebody told you, listen, brother, I know where there is a whole bunch of gold buried, and they have evidence, you'll quit your job to go with them to dig that gold. You know it. You know it, and I know it. If they told you, I know a place where there's some gold buried and some silver buried, all you need to do is get you a shovel. It takes us about 2 days to get there. Listen, you're quitting everything because you're going to get that gold, you're going to get that silver. And they tell you it's not that deep. Man, you're going to fill your trunk with it. Well, why wouldn't we do that with God's divine wisdom? Why wouldn't we do that with God's divine understanding? You better come back next week, boy. We're going to get into Solomon next week, and it's going to be divine. Father, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you that we have good judgment, that we are discovering knowledge and discernment. We are discerning through our life. Why? Because we have asked for divine wisdom. We believe you to do it. We trust you to do it. We thank you to do it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We give you praise and glory. We honor you this day, and we thank you for divine wisdom. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, come back next week. If you have not ever sown a seed into this ministry, I challenge you today. Sow a seed, sow a seed, sow a seed. If we have been blessing you, bless us. We've given you spiritual things. Give us some carnal things. We want to continue to keep magnifying his name and to keep dispensing his word. And the best way to do that is for us to be on these stations talking about the pure and simple abundance of grace. God bless you. God keep you. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you next week. This is Stephen McCrary once again with the abundance of grace. If this abundance of grace message has been blessing you, sow a seed right now. You can go to www.aograce.com and you can give securely there. www.aograce.com, or you can send a check or money order to P.O. Box 663, O'Fallon, Missouri 63366. The abundance of grace, P.O. Box 663, O'Fallon, Missouri 63366. Will you be a blessing? I guarantee you, if you are, God will open up the windows of heaven and he'll pour you out a blessing that you don't have room enough to receive. Until next week, this is Stephen McCrary with the abundance of grace.